Well, speaking of 2022, let's talk about the rejection, your rejection of Isambayan's invitation. We're going to talk about that. But first, when you heard that you were actually being considered, what went through your mind? What were the thoughts going through your mind, considering that some of the personalities in that coalition were the people who put your family through the ringer?
Well, at the beginning, akala ko nagbibiro lang sila. When they, you know, brought it up, kasi, or, yeah, kasi di ba parang, you know, where I started in politics, right? Carmina, na 2013, the way I was bashed, and then, what, 6 years after, kasama na ako dun sa pagpipilian for the two top positions in the country. And then, ang next reaction is, I guess, truly flattered. Na for me, it's a validation and recognition na, na I'm doing my role as a public servant.
Did you also see it as somehow these people, these personalities trying to really reach out and bridge the divide? Or was there a part of you that also said, what is this? Where are you guys coming from?
Ako kasi, Carmina, after parang yung what we went through in 2016, hindi na ako, it's not about the personalities anymore. It's about what is the, ano yung pinaglalaban eh? Ano ba yung gusto nilang mangyari, di ba? So, for me, it's a non-issue.
It's a non-issue. You have forgiven former Senator Antonio Trillanes and even former co-auditor Heidi Mendoza.
Senator Trillanes, before he left the Senate, we were able to talk already. So parang nagkaroon na kami ng ano ba yan, clearing of the air. Kumbaga.
What did you guys talk about? Did he apologize?
Kinda. Parang he explained where he was coming from, why he did that. So parang meron na kaming ano, parang at least when he left the Senate, hindi na kami nag-iiwasan sa hallway tsaka sa elevator, di ba? So parang anyway, there was already a closure.
Between you and your former colleague, but what about between him and your brother and your father and the rest of the family?
I cannot speak for them, but alam mo, I think that is something that I learned from my father, Carmina, na hindi nagtatanim ng ano ng sama ng loob, di ba? If it's for a greater cause, it should be regardless kung sino yung kasama mo doon sa grupo na yun.
Well, the coalition, as you know, it aims to put up a united front to go against the possible administration slate. Do you think this is possible, knowing what you know about the coalition, considering, of course, as well, the colorful history between and among the people behind it? Do you think that this is actually possible?
So, but you know, just at the end of the day, everybody should just learn the art of compromise, diba? Yung members of One Sambayan, syempre yung criteria na sinet nila, for me, very idealistic, right? But at some point, they also need to manage their criteria and their expectations, because I mean, I think that's part of politics, the art of compromise and balancing things.
So when you talk about balancing things, what do you think this coalition should be able to address, should be able to do in order to achieve that goal of theirs, to put up this united front against the administration?
I guess they really need to get that commitment dun sa mga pinagpipilian nila na, you know, at the end of the day, if we decide na ito yung candidate, sana there will only be one candidate, right? But alam naman natin in politics, medyo napakahirap nun na paatrasin yung may mga ambition for higher office.
Bakit naging madali sa'yo, Senator Binay? Why was it easy for you to reject the invitation? Why did you reject it?
Hindi, una-una, siguro, I am thankful na they considered me. But for me, Carmina, ang laki ng problema natin, whoever will be the next president or vice president will be facing, kumbaga, a tough job. Mahirap na ngayon trabaho to begin with, but because of this pandemic, mas mahirap pa siya, right? And I can't commit 100% dun sa trabaho. Parang mas nangibabaw yung I need to be a mother first at this point. Kasi yung you know what happened with us dun sa 2016. I cannot let my kids go through that again. So yun yung talaga parang automatic. I cannot make them sacrifice again. I mean, they already sacrificed when I entered politics in 2013. And then they sacrificed again when my father ran for 2016. And then papasok na naman ako ulit this 2022. Parang it's not fair to them anymore.
Is that something that you've learned being the daughter of a politician as well? Your father has been in politics for decades. Are you trying not to repeat what you had to go through as well?
I think kami magkakapatid, Carmina, we're lucky kasi nandun kami dun sa age na hindi naman social media yung validation, di ba? Yung kids namin, they're different now. It's a different world for them where very important sa kanila yung acceptance mo sa social media. Yung pag-bully sa kanila is virtual, right?
Yeah.
Katulad dati na pag kunyari may classmate ka na mag-bully sa'yo, you can already confront each other and, you know.
At saka natatapos once you enter your home. Eh ngayon, yeah. Very porous because of the internet, di ba? Go ahead.
Tsaka, di ba, yung kaaway mo, it's just between you and your batchmate or your classmate. Ito hindi, it's between you and you don't know who else, right? Yeah. Lahat sila pwedeng makisali or makigulo. Hmm.
Yeah, so if you're not, your term is until 2025, correct?
Yes. So parang for me, you know, I can still serve. I still have 3 more years as a senator and I think as a senator, I can do my job at the same time as a mother and as a senator. But as a mother and whether it's president or vice president, I don't think kaya kong ipagsabay. The commitment for that higher office should be 100%. Kumbaga, everything should just be second place. And dapat first place yung trabaho mo as president or vice president. And that I cannot commit to.
And we're going to have to leave it at that. Senator Nancy Binay, always a pleasure talking to you. You continue to take care and keep safe. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot.